everyone, welcome back to the Piercing Outlet. In today's video, we're going to be talking about how to get rid of piercing bumps, how to go from having a piercing bump to going bump free. I'm actually one of those people who gets piercing bumps quite often on all my piercings. I got out my nose, both of my cartilages, and even my belly button. So today we're going to be talking about why these bumps occur and how to get rid of them. And also, before we get into today's video, if you actually have a piercing bump, then give this video a thumbs up. And also, if you're not already part of the Piercing Outlet, then be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that way you never miss any jewelry or piercing type videos. Today we're talking specifically about piercing bumps or irritation bumps. I just want to put this out here first that not every bump equals a keloid. I know that's a very common thing that people think here on the internet or even in person. When I used to pierce ears, a lot of people say, oh, I got a keloid, but a keloid is actually scar tissue. It would be permanent. The only way to really remove them is to have a dermatologist remove them. But today we're talking about piercing bumps. And once you actually find out the cause of your irritation, then that bump will go away. So there are four common things that irritate your piercing, which we're gonna talk about right now. So the first thing is poor quality jewelry. The best thing to get pierced with is titanium. Titanium is one of the best things to get pierced with. It's something that doctors use because it is hypoallergenic and it's a safe metal to use on people. So I was actually pierced with stainless steel. It didn't work for me, so I ended up switching to 14 karat gold. That's something that worked for me. If you feel as though stainless steel doesn't work for you, you do want to try different things. It's all trial and error. If you guys are interested in other gold options, I will leave a link below to a place where you can find gold body jewelry. The second thing is going to be trauma. You want to avoid playing with your piercing. Once you snag it, those bumps can occur. And also, if you find as though when you wake up your ear is really sore and you find one of those bumps, I would recommend trying sleeping with an airplane pillow. That way you're not leaning on your ears. Number three is aftercare. Now this is a big one. Most piercers are going to recommend something called a sterile saline solution or sterile wound wash, which you can find in the first aid aisle. I personally prefer H2Ocean. It's pretty much salt water in a can. You just spray it on your piercing and you're good to go. I will leave a link to both below. Now, things that can actually irritate your piercing are tea tree oil. They're not meant for these type of bumps, irritation bumps. They can just irritate your piercings even more. Any type of like crushed up pills, A&D ointment, petroleum jelly, alcohol peroxide, these things are not good for piercings. So they can actually irritate your piercings. I would stay away from them, either H2Ocean or the sterile wound wash. Now, if you feel as though that none of the above fits you, like none of those situations apply to you because you are wearing great quality jewelry, you haven't had any trauma to your ear, and also you're using the right aftercare, then it could actually be the angle that maybe you were pierced. So if you're not sure, then I would definitely see a reputable piercer. If you don't feel comfortable seeing the same piercer, then maybe I would go to a different one. I would recommend someone that is part of the APP, the Association of Professional Piercers. You can find one at safepiercing.org. You can find one that's closest to you. They're highly trained professionals and they will definitely be able to help you and guide you in the right direction. So once you actually figure out what's irritating your piercing, then you should start to see improvement in your piercing bump and it will eventually go away. Mine took about 2 weeks and that's because it really took me a while to figure out what was going on with my piercing. So once I figured it out, I switched to a different metal and started cleaning it with H2Ocean instead of what I was using, because I was using, I'm pretty sure, like what Piercing Magoda and like Walmart, those places, that little bottle. That didn't work for me. So once I stopped using that, I was good to go. So comment below what you guys were pierced with. I'd love to know everyone's answer because everyone is coming from all different places around the world. And also, don't forget to subscribe for more jewelry and piercing videos. That's it. I'll see you guys in my next video.